there's these two disciples trudging along the road to Emmaus, and they meet this mysterious figure who gets into conversation with them. And he says, what have you been talking about? And they say, well, haven't you heard about all these things that are going on in Jerusalem? Very confusing things. Some of our number, these ladies went to the tomb and they found angels there, or so they say, and they claim that Jesus is risen from the dead. And you get the sense, don't you, that it's been a bit much for them, and so they're heading home to Emmaus. And of course, in this conversation, their hearts start burning. They're drawn to this mysterious stranger that they've met. And when they get to their destination, it's getting late, and they say, come in, have a meal with us, stay the night, don't go on now. And so this figure comes in, and they share a meal. And of course, in the breaking of bread, Jesus is revealed to them. And immediately he disappears. They hot-tail back to Jerusalem and say, we've encountered the risen Lord in the breaking of bread. He became known to us as we shared communion with each other. And there's this wonderful sense, isn't it, that story reveals something to us about supernatural hospitality. That in the context of hospitality, something sacramental happens. That as we break bread with the stranger is revealed to us as Christ. And Jesus once said that in one of his parables, the parable of sheep and the goats in Matthew 25. He said, I was hungry and you fed me. I was thirsty and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger and you welcomed me in. And the people say, when did we ever do that? And he said, whatever you did for the least of these, you did it for me. As we seek to welcome the stranger, there's a mysterious sense in which we are welcoming in Christ, that Jesus becomes known to us. And as we host Christ, isn't it interesting, Christ becomes the host. He's the one who takes the bread and blesses it and breaks it, and it becomes the channel by which we encounter him afresh. And so I want to encourage you this Easter to welcome the stranger. It might just be a friendly greeting on the road. It might be an offer of food or hospitality or lodging. But as we do so, let's encounter the risen Jesus and recognize there is something sacramental, something supernatural about hospitality. Happy Easter.